Up to my age of 70, I changed 5 times my life. So I have the feeling that I lived up to now 6 different lives. The first changing was in 70. I was a fanatic rock climber, especially rock climber. In the Dolomites, also a little bit in the Mont Blanc area. And my dreams were high up on, not high mountains, but on high difficulties. New lines, more difficult than everybody active before me. Climbing on Nanga Parbat on the Rupal face, losing my brother, losing part of my toes, losing a little bit of fingertips, I was in a trap because my parents, my brothers, they all pushed that I should quit with mountaineering. And in my situation, I was not either hoping that I could go back to the mountains. But after a few months, I understood that I will never anymore be able to climb on the same level I did before Nanga Parbat. And I understood also that if I would quit forever, I would be an unhappy person because all my dreams are stuck in my head and I could not either divide the responsibility for our tragedy on Nanga Parbat with the death brother. And so I decided, it was a decision, now I would like to go to the higher mountains where we go on easier ground, bigger dimension, where my toes are not so important, where rock climbing is not so important, and I can take my brother in my mind with me. And so I begin my second activity, a second life, totally different from my first enthusiasm for rock climbing. And in the second period, I was able to fulfill all my dreams. I had many dreams that they were growing, and I did all the crazy things alone on the 8,000 meter peaks and without oxygen and traversing 28,000 meter peaks. And just when I became able to traverse the 2 Gashaprons, I had the feeling now my possibilities on the 8,000 meter peaks are running out. There is no big deal. And I decided I will climb them all if I have the physical power and a little bit of luck. But afterwards, I need a new goal, a new challenge. And so after the last 8,000 meter peak after Lhotse, I climbed in 86, I was really free. I came to the base camp like a young, free man, open to the next period. And I changed totally. So I learned to cope with cold. I learned to how the people like Shackleton and Scott and Nansen behaved on the North and the South Pole. I was ready then to cross the Gobi Desert as the first thing, because this is very near to a mountain. The Gobi Desert is an area where once was a mountain chain, bigger than the whole Alps. And this mountain chain became a desert because the frost and the wind destroyed the whole mountain chain. And so crossing the Gobi Desert was like crossing a whole mountain chain. But the Chinese did not give me a permit. In Mongolia then, the Soviets were ruling, so no chance to get a permit, so I forget about it. And I followed Shackleton's idea, crossing Antarctica. And when I did it, I had the feeling this is much more adventuring than climbing, because I was much more exposed in the middle of Antarctica. It was not so difficult, not so dangerous. Some crevasses, but no stonefall, no avalanches. Some crevasses, cold was quite difficult, wind, okay. I had a good partner who was able to navigate. I was not able to navigate, but this was his responsibility. And I learned from him to navigate, and afterwards I had everything, every possibility in my hand again. I crossed Greenland the long way from south east to northwest. I crossed the Gobi Desert, the Taklamakan, smaller deserts, also the Tenere in the Sahara. I crossed lately the Yellow Continental North in Patagonia. And then I had a problem again. I fell from my own surrounding house wall in Yuval, the castle I'm living in the summer. I climbed up for 6 meters because the main key was not in the right place. The children were out because we were taking lunch before, dinner before. And it was raining and it was totally night and they were shivering. And I said, okay, no problem. I know a way I can overcome the surrounding wall of my castle. 6 meters climbing up. And on the way down, inner side, again 6 meters, I lost a halt because it was wet. I was springing, but I could not see where I spring. I could not move my knees. And I was clapping on the ground on a granite with one leg, and the whole heel was broken in 100 pieces. So I have a doctor brother, and he came next morning in the hospital, looked at me and said, if you are unlucky, no more expeditions. Your foot will never anymore be okay. And so I called my wife, I remember very well, and said, probably I have to change life again. Please go in my office, and there is a cabinet, and there is many papers. There's an idea for a book I prepared months ago. Bring it to me. I'm beginning to write a book. In case of emergency, I will become a writer. But the young doctors were able to save my foot. They cut out a part of my bone on the hip, and they put it down in the foot, and I'm quite well hiking. I did some expeditions afterwards. But this was also the, the motivation to change again. And afterwards, I did the studies on the Yeti. I knew that around the Yeti there is a reality, but not a legend and reality. And I went to Tibet to study, to speak with people, to take photographs. And later on, I followed not a scientific life, because I am not a scientist. And I was missing the ability to work as a scientist. But I studied all the holy mountains worldwide in all the continents. I did not climb all of them, but partly of them. And I became a man or person being interested not in the summits anymore, but in the mountain culture, in the people which are living in the mountains, which are giving history and also life to the mountains. And the next changement was when they asked me to run for the European Parliament. A group of politicians came and said, you have a chance to be voted. And I said, okay, I do it. If I have not to be part of the party, if I'm a free person, without an independent person, I won a seat. I was 5 years in the parliament in Strasbourg and in Brussels. But this was not exactly my life, but I'm very happy that I did it, because I learned to be able to do compromises, like in politics is necessary. But after 5 years, I decided freely I will not run for a second period, otherwise I would become a professional politician. I would not like to be a professional politician. And I begin to tell, as a storyteller, through my museum, the whole mountain knowledge, history, all around the mountains. And in this moment, before beginning, I had the feeling it's becoming maybe economically very, very tough. And I invited three directors of famous museums, one from Munich, one from Roma, one from Zurich. And I told them what I would like to do. In a province, in South Tyrol, in my homeland, I would build up a central museum and smaller museums around for putting some special issues inside. And they said, Mr. Messner, no chance. Go maybe to London, or go to Paris, or go to Munich, and there on the edge of the city you can do one house and tell your mountaineering stories. But running a museum is a very costly thing. I think you cannot handle it. And I told them, but I think my power would be to put these museums in the right spot where nature outside is carrying the issue inside. So I was willing to bring the rock museum on a rock peak, the ice museum under a glacier, the mountain people museum in a farm area in the mountains, the Holy Mountain Museum on the place where Ötzi, the famous Iceman, you heard about the Frozen Fritz or Iceman, where he had his cultural place. And I found all these places. I did it one after the next, again a museum. Every 3-4 years in the last year I opened once. And it's functioning, because it's exactly functioning like it was my dream, that one museum is the motor for the other one. So normally, if now some people are visiting one of our houses, they are coming next year again and they see the second house, because they are in such good positions, and the positions and the view from the positions are the base of the success also of the museums. And now I'm finishing. In July, the last museum will be open. My daughter is taking over. She is able to handle it. She studied these things. And I will be free again, because I am not somebody who is following the old dreams. The dreams are fulfilled. And I will look in the next 2 years for the next life.